Hey, this is Victor. Hope you're doing well. Okay, so today I wanted to talk to you about how to lay out the homepage of your website. So a lot of people kind of misunderstand or don't really appreciate like what's the purpose of the homepage and what you're supposed to do and the function that it's trying to serve. And so in this video, I'm going to walk you through kind of our process of how we think of the homepage of the website, how we lay out a homepage, and what are some things we do to kind of give structure to the homepage to make it as easy as possible for the visitor to find what they're looking for, and easy as the business as possible for them to make more sales and get more customers. So let's watch. Okay, so to walk you through kind of our process and how we think of kind of laying out the homepage of a website, I'm using kind of a case study example here. So this is an actual project we're in the middle of redesigning. So this is the actual current website from the client. We did not design this site here. And so I'm just going to kind of walk you through how we typically structure the website to think about like what you can do to lay out your site. And keep in mind the purpose of all of this is to kind of make more conversions, get more customers, get more people happy with their experience and then with your experience as well to either sell your service or product. Like that's the end goal here, and it's always good to keep that in mind first and foremost. Okay, so this is the existing site, right? And the first step that we do is just establish the site map for the new website. And so in this particular instance, what we do is what we always do is we put it in a Google Sheet, right? And we put it as a spreadsheet. And here where it says top level, that is the equivalent of what's going on here. This is your top level navigation menu. And this is the site map for your site is really kind of like the skeleton or the architecture for your whole website. It's the bones upon which the rest of the body will lay. And it's the most important process here. And so, kind of your website is really just a series of random pages on the internet, and this site map is what gives it structure and meaning to the visitor. And so the first step is just understanding what it is. And so you'll have, your previous website site map will, typically we put that together first and then you might change it. And so in this particular instance, we did, they really wanted to beef up their real estate one. I think the real estate section on the current site is just an individual page. I think it just has industrial commercial. So I guess it's two pages. And they don't really have, for example, their industry section. We actually had to move the industry section and now it's a top level. So this is an update here. But their industry section is much bigger on the new site than it is on the previous site. But the first step is just understanding kind of what are the pages, what are the hierarchies of those pages, how do they relate to each other? And that is done through the sitemap. And the reason that's super important is because, the way I think about the website itself, especially the homepage, the homepage is really just a series of advertisements for the rest of your website, right? Most people, when they come to the site, they're looking for something specifically and they're trying to find it. And so what you want to do is make it as easy as possible for the visitor to find the thing that they're looking for and not have to think too long. If they think too long, they're going to leave, right? And so you see here, they have kind of all the stuff that they do, and it is here, but it's kind of confusing and it's kind of not easy to know what it is that you're looking for. Another thing that we did also, just kind of before we did this sitemap or as we did the sitemap, was just review their Google Analytics and like what is the thing, that so what's bringing people to the site, number one, and then number two, once they're on the site, what are the most visited pages of the site? And it turns out that their auctions was like far and away the most visited pages of the site. And so that's like the most, preeminent thing that we want to call attention to. And then what they also wanted to call attention to was their new real estate pages and the various services that they offer. And so like I said, this is their current site. This is how it is. And so here's how we laid it out with the new site. So this is still under development, but here's some thoughts on things that you can do. So number one, you just want the navigation to be as clean as possible. You want it to be easy to see the navigation. My rule is I would never put more than like seven navigation links in the navigation bar. I think even like five is a good number that we snuck in this industries page. If you're going to go over five, then like get rid of the homepage. Most people know that they can click on the logo and that'll go to the homepage. I'm a big believer, like the hero section is like the most important part of your site, right? And so the purpose of the hero section is you want to make it as clear as possible in as few sentences as possible what this company does, and ideally if there's some kind of call to action with it. So this is a company that does auction and liquidations, and like this is like their main statement of purpose. Really, it also has another statement of purpose below, and that's fine. Sometimes you want to have one that's kind of different than the other, and that's okay. So this is where it kind of gets into the advertisement section, and this is where you can kind of play with the layout for your site and things that you can do. So, you know, the way I think about it is, you know, these are their individual services. So we have their services listed here. It says asset recovery, asset appraisal, and turnkey sales. And those are the same things here. And really, you know, it's just a picture of their sitemap. That's all that the homepage is. It's just a picture of all the pages of their site, probably in the most important order, and, you know, in the things that they, you know, want people to focus on. So they have their real estate services listed here, or I should say their regular services listed here, which are their auction services. And then they have their real estate services listed here, which are listed down here, right? And this is a way for people, they know that they're looking for something particular, and this allows them to kind of get to it as soon as possible. I like to give people lots of different ways of getting to the same content. So you have the main navigation bar. I also think people don't like to read for some reason these days, and they just like to see pictures. And so to make this as highly visual as possible, skimmable as possible, I think is key. And so that people can kind of see the picture of the thing that they're looking for and dive in from there. So then what I also often like to do is add stats. So these are not directional. Like I think of the content as like, there's directional content where you're directing people towards another page, and then there's just informational content. And so that informational content could be about the company, about the history, some stats, testimonials, logos, any partner logos. All of those are great things to add that are not directional. They just kind of boost the credibility and make it more likely that people will stick around or believe the company, etc. So as I said, the auctions is the most important thing. So this is kind of a slider. The thing with this is they have different auctions, right? So it's hard to know, you know, there's competing interests here, but I like to have people focus on one thing at a time. And so people can actually dive through and see the individual auctions here. But the very first listing is just the call to action to the auction page. So if I clicked here, it would just take you to the auction landing page. And this is essentially the ad for the auction landing page. And then you could see more individual auctions. So again, it's just an ad for this section. Then this one here is an ad for the real estate section. And so because, you know, there's different ways of doing the same thing. You know, we had kind of real estate stuff here, but we also have real estate stuff here as well. But when people are going here, it's just going to the top level page. It's just going to the real estate landing page. And that then gives people more decisions to make. And the challenge is, you know, you can have people, you know, in this particular real estate section, there's like four different sections, right? And so you can either direct them from the homepage to those subpages, right? Or you could direct them to the landing page. And it just depends on kind of what the visitor's needs are and what you think that they might want to do. In this particular case, we're just doing it to the landing page. Sometimes, like this example here, it actually goes to those subpages. In this case, it's doing both, and that's perfectly all right. You don't want to underestimate the user's ability to get to stuff. You want to make it as easy as possible, and I love redundancy. I love having multiple ways of getting to the same stuff, and that's very important. And then, you know, one thing I like to include, especially on bigger sites that have a lot of content, is the big ass footer, where it's just a footer that has a ton of links that allows people to get to all the content that they're looking for, kind of Craigslist style. And I find that to be very useful. So, you know, especially on a bigger site, some people like to look at pictures, but some people just like to see a series of links, and this is useful for that purpose. So, you know, that's kind of my philosophy. If we look at like apple.com, so if you look at like their homepage, for example, it's such a big site, and actually I don't love what they're doing like with this particular one right now, but usually it's awesome. So, but They're going, kind of not to what I just mentioned. They're just kind of showing their news or arcade or other things that they're trying to feature at that particular moment. But what I just said, the whole advertisement thing, it's for any landing page. And so like a landing page is a page, like I said, that was directing you to another page. It's not there for the end result. It's directing you towards additional content. So if we look at the Mac landing page or probably any of the other ones, it follows that format. You'll see that these are the different pages that they're directing you to MacBook and Pro and Air, iMac, etc. They want to highlight the iMac, so the iMac's the first thing that you see. But then it's just a picture of MacBook Air, and then it's just a picture of MacBook Pro. It really doesn't do anything more. There's the picture of the MacBook Mini and, iMac Pro. And that's all it is. It's just a series of pictures of the content on the site. You see accessories for Mac, shop now. That's all it is. These are just a series of advertisements for the content. And so that's really how you should think about, kind of the homepage of your site or any landing page of your site. It's just a series of advertisements. And so advertisements are pretty pictures, calls to action, just enough information to pique people's interest or let them know that that's the thing that they're looking for. And then you're directing them to that particular page. And no more than that. You don't need to sell. You don't need to, it's not telling you to buy it now. It's just telling you more information where you can kind of find out now. And then you're on that particular page and you can learn more and dive in from there. So that's how we think about the homepage layout for a website. Hopefully you found this useful. If you did, please feel free to subscribe, leave a like on this video. And if you need help with your website project, visit thomasdigital.com. We offer a free mock-up of your new website before you sign or pay for anything. So go to thomasdigital.com to learn more.